There they go again, harassing his kid so easily. His name is Andy, he grew up right down the street from me. I barely know him though, I just see him in school while passing him. Usually followed by two kids giggling in the back of him. I don't know why they feel a need to interfere, and I'll be honest, the kid is obviously a little weird. He's got a stutter plus always talks to himself, but it is clear to me they shouldn't mess with him. He probably wish they'd disappear, like yeah, he's different. So, he ain't causing harm to anyone. Yeah, he might annoy him, not on purpose though. He's never done something intentionally offensive like these other kids, like yelling stop being a retard when they see him mumbling, or call him a faggot when he's saying something awkward. Yeah, he lives with it, but he shouldn't have to any longer. He's just a kid like any of us. And matter of fact, next time I see it, I'ma say something and have his back. They're abusing him. Every day gets worse cause people accept it as they become used to it. And he don't stand up, but what can you do with that hate against you? You call him out, you call the spaz with some anger issues. They hear but they don't listen, senseless. They're hearing that bullies are everywhere, thinking that here must be the exception. But it's so alive and it's so true. They got open eyes but they don't view. They got growing minds that they don't use, and it's pulverizing our whole youth. But to be honest, most of these bullies don't mean any harm. They're just kids like any of us. They like to be in charge, they like attention. They just lack guidance in getting it, so they put others down. None of us are always innocent, but that don't make it right. Cause again I'm watching Andy get tortured by two of his peers with no reason in sight. And I know he knows I'm watching. He sees me paying attention, and it's getting worse and worse. I hope he knows that I respect him. Show up to school and I was nervous. He always came to this class, I wonder what was the purpose. The same class had the two kids who'd been messing with him, but without a target, both of them just blended right in. 20 minutes later, the class was pretty quiet. As Andy walks through the door, he was shaking and crying. As all heads slowly in sync turn, he pauses and pulls a pistol out of his front pocket. The girl screamed, the boy sat there terrified. Nobody expected this, but everyone knew the reason why. And before anyone could say something fully, within seconds, two bullets flew into his bullies. More screams as the bodies collapsed. I felt I should say something cause I was the only one who had his back. I said it's over, Andy, they're dead, you had your wish. He turned to me and said, you were the third on my list.